was in, amen, it's in turmoil. It's in a sad state.
Yes, it is.
But for the church, for the bride of Christ, amen, we recognize the times and the seasons that we're living in.
All right.
So therefore, amen, we don't become so dismayed, amen, that we don't realize, amen, which way we're going to turn. We're going to turn to the Lord.
All right.
Amen. So the two words, amen, is to be encouraged. I know sometimes we say that, amen, to be encouraged, but we're going to look at some things, amen, that happen, what it means truly to be encouraged. When we think about this and we see the news every time you wake up, they used to sing the songs, tragedies on every side, amen. It seems like every time you turn on the TV, somebody's trying to blow something up or somebody up, mass shootings, mass killings. But for the saints of God, we need to understand that God really is really, really in control, amen. But the world, amen, says man has become more wicked from his youth. But so our subject, amen, is be encouraged. But the person I want you to understand that we're talking about is the Apostle Paul, amen, and the God that he served, amen.
Right.
So we realize something here. But what I want to do is kind of set the understanding that Paul just in short here, he went through some things. And so it is with the church and the body of Christ. So in 2 Corinthians, we look at the 11th chapter, verse 23. He says, are they ministers of Christ? He says, I speak as a fool. He says, I am more. In labors, more abundant. In stripes, above measure. In prison, he said, more frequent. He said, in death, often. He said, of the Jews, five times received our 40 stripes, save one. He tells me, he said, thrice was I beaten with rods, and once was I stoned. Thrice I suffered shipwreck. A night and day I've been bought what in the deep. So he's beginning to tell them all the things that befell him.
Right.
And so now we begin to understand that even though, amen, he's a great writer, amen, the author, amen, of the books, amen, these epistles, but he went through something. They have a testimony that God was with him. He's in journeys often. He's in perils of waters, in perils of robbers. And then he said, in perils by my own, amen, countrymen. And so this is what we're saying here. People of him, amen, he was in perils. He said, by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in the wilderness, in perils in the sea, in perils among false brethren. So begin to understand that Apostle Paul just didn't show up, amen, and I'm going to write these words, amen. He bore the marks of Christ in his body.
Yes, he did.
No one, amen, is beating us 40 stripes. No one is locking us up in prison. But we have a free reign, amen, to tell somebody about this man called Jesus. And so we begin to understand something. There's always a time, amen, that we can testify of the goodness of Jesus. We've heard the term before, learn how to walk and talk, chew gum at the same time. And sometimes people, you'd be surprised, amen. Some people can't walk and chew gum at the same time. Some people can't walk and talk at the same time. But this walking and talking that I'm talking about, it's about walking for Jesus, amen, and telling somebody about Christ at the same time. I'm not talking about, amen, when it's all good, amen, you can tell somebody about the Lord. I'm talking about when things are not going your way. When you're caught, amen, in divers places, can you still tell somebody about God? Can you still walk, amen, this walk and still talk about the goodness of Jesus? Sometimes, amen, the enemy comes in and he gives us, amen, buffing us about, so therefore we shut our mouths and we start complaining about the situations that we're in. But I want us, amen, to be encouraged on this morning. We all have the ability, saints of God, to be encouraged.
Yeah.
Amen. We can tell somebody, man, about the goodness of Jesus. We can tell somebody about repentance and about baptism. We can tell somebody about the joy of the Lord is our strength. But we got to have it, amen, in such a way that when the enemy comes in to try to stop us, he says, I'm going to let nothing move me. I'm still going to testify of his goodness. At one point, amen, we all needed to be encouraged. Whether you realize it or not, amen, we all need to be encouraged. And where else can a man find encouragement except for the house of God, among the people of God, from the saints of God? So understand something. The word, amen, encouraged, comes from the Greek word, which it says is parakleo, which means to call to one side. It means, amen, to encourage. It means to strengthen. It means to comfort. And so in other words, when we come to one side, amen, we're not coming to that side to tell them, amen, about the things, amen, of the world. We've come to that side to encourage them about the goodness of Jesus. We come to that side, amen, not to whisper sweet nothing in their ears, but we come, amen, to tell them, amen, that Jesus is able to keep you if you keep your mind on him. And so we come alongside of them, amen, to help them, amen, to encourage them, say, you can make it. And so in other words, when we comfort them, we comfort them with words, amen, that God has already put to the test. That's why he said, comfort one another with these words. We speak life into situations and not death. We all, amen, need to become and realize that we can be encouragers, especially during these last and evil days. This is a word, praise be to God, that we don't want to speak too often. Amen. Stick to your guns. If you tell somebody I'm sticking to my guns, they might think you got a gun in your pocket and you might end up losing your life. But it's a term that the world uses, but it simply means to refuse to change and believe our actions. Amen. So for the saints of God, I'm not going to tell you stick to your guns, but I'm going to tell you stick with Jesus. My God, if you stick with Jesus, in other words, you don't compromise, you don't change what you believe, but you stick to the one that brought you here. You stick to the one, amen, that's able to keep you from falling. If you keep your mind on him, there ain't way, man, to lean on him when times get rough. I know we got husbands, I know we got wives, I know, amen, that we got some friends in the house of God, but lean on Christ. Tell him, amen, what you need, and take time to listen what God has to say.
Yes.
That's always, amen, room for improvement in our lives. If we take a self-inventory and say, listen, I need to work on my prayer life. I need to work on fasting on Wednesdays. I need to work on, amen, that quiet time alone with the Lord. I need to work on some things. And so that's what David says. He had to encourage himself in the Lord. And so sometimes, amen, how do I encourage myself in the Lord? It's meaning that no matter what comes or what befalls me, I still got to have in the forefront of my mind that God said he'll never leave me nor forsake me. But the forsaking comes in when the enemy comes in like a flood, and then we want to tip out on God. That's the time, amen, you come running. He said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And that's why, saints of God, you got to have some spiritual songs down the inside so you can start encouraging yourself. I'm not talking about some of these songs of the world today. I'm talking about some of them old songs, glory be to God. The blood of Jesus, my God, it still saves. It goes to the highest mountain, even to the lowest of valleys. The blood of Jesus has not lost its power. Amen. It's still saved. People are still speaking in tongues. People still receive the Holy Ghost. But this word, praise be to God. God will keep us if we want to be kept. Understand something here. In this scripture, in this text, I want us to look at something real carefully here. In verse number 14, my God, he said, and when Paul was now about to open his mouth, how have you ever been there? And sometimes, when you sit down at the negotiating table, you're about to say, I'll take this much. But before you open your mouth, he said, hold on. Let me pass this offer sheet unto you. It was more than what you was getting ready to ask for. Because understand something. He would have put that table right back and let you spoke that thing. You wanted 50,000, they're going to give you 60. But if you understand, I'll take 50, guess what he would have done? He would have pulled it back and said, I'll see you the offer sheet tomorrow. So sometimes, saints of God, before we begin to open our mouths, just sit there for a minute. That's why he said, be swift to hear, my God. Slow to speak and slow to wrath. Sometimes I know what it says, but we get here. He said, listen, and Galileo said to the Jews, he said, it was a matter of Rome, a wicked, a lewdness. He said, if this was a matter of him doing something contrary to the law of the nation, amen, he said, then, listen, I can take care of this thing. I can handle it for you. But he goes on to tell him something. He said, listen to this thing. He said, but it'd be a question of words and names. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. He says about names. What do you think he's talking about? The name of Jesus. That's why Paul was in the temple, amen. He was constantly, amen, disputing that Jesus is the Christ. In other words, the name was Jesus, amen. And the Word was the Christ, which means the anointed one. Jesus Christ is not his first and last name. It signifies that Jesus is the anointed one. And so Galileo is telling, he said, listen, if this thing was a matter, amen, that you all doing about the name and the words, he said, it's in your law. You guys take care of that among yourselves. He said, I ain't got nothing to do with this. And so what am I saying, saints of God? The still saves. The world needs to know that there's no other name given under heaven whereby we must be saved except the saving name of Jesus. The world needs to know that the word of God is the word that's going to keep them in these last and evil days. But sometimes, amen, to back up for one more time, he's in that ninth verse there. He said, be not afraid, but speak and hold not the peace. Don't be afraid.
Don't be
speak and hold not your peace. Some people look at that as being aggression, but he said, listen, he said, but don't silence yourself because of the aggression of people. He said, because I got much people in this city. He said, I am with thee, my God. He said, nobody is going to harm you. Saints of God, when God has something for you to do, I don't care who or what comes in your way, my God, he'll see it through, but you got to be a willing vessel. Paul, my God, he had to go to Rome, my God. And so therefore, whatever befell him, he knew, my God, that was not his end. We got to understand something. This is not the end for the church, for we have a God that fight for us. We have a God, if we stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. So my word for you this morning is to be encouraged, and watch God move on your behalf. I remember I say this all the time. In my naval experience, we used to have something they called an emergency breakaway. In other words, there were ships, my God. One might be refueling ship, and one would come alongside. And so one of the ships would maintain its course and speed in one direction. And the ship that needed fuel, it would just come up alongside. In other words, he said, I'm maintaining my course and I'm keeping the same speed. In other words, don't worry about me changing. You compensate to whatever you need to do. And so the word of God, saints, the word of God is not going to change. It's going to maintain what it is. So when you come alongside this word, you are the one that got to make the adjustment. You are the one that has to make the change, because God's word is constant. And when you come alongside it, I thank and praise God. Not only does the Holy Ghost, which is the Comforter, he just not only come alongside us, he dwells now within us. He said, the Father will send the Comforter in my name. And sometimes what begins to happen is this ship, sometimes it will lose its steering. In other words, its ability to maneuver. And therefore they say it's an emergency breakaway. Some saints will come alongside saints and they're talking all kinds of things. But when you realize that they're not being led by the Spirit of God, you need to declare emergency breakaway. You need to get out of there as quick and soon as possible, because this person, it's not time to encourage you. They're trying to discourage you. They're trying to stop you from falling. This man called Jesus, somebody, my God, need to break away from that relationship that's calling you to miss out on church. Somebody need to break away from that situation that calling you to doubt God. Sometimes financial difficulties, we need to break away from it. Separate yourself from the problem, my God, and maintain a proper relationship with God. You might not be able to teach Sunday school a Bible study. You might not be able, my God, to lead praise and worship. You might not be able to sing a song to high heaven. But he said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. He said, be encouraged. You have the ability to come along somebody beside us and be encouraged. So take courage in the Lord. My God, you know he's playing you. My God, you're going to trust him. I'm going to stand right with you until you come up out of this situation. Just like God said, I'm not going to leave you nor forsake you. You got to believe that I'm here for you. Saints of God, the enemy wants you to believe that the body of Christ is not here for you. This building has not moved. No, it hasn't since its inception. The foundation might have slipped here and there. It might have sprung a leak here and there. But my God, it has maintained a facility, a house of worship. And so it is with the saints of God. God said, I need somebody that's going to be stable in these last and evil days. I need somebody that can continue to walk this walk and to talk this talk, so you can come alongside another saint of God that needs to be encouraged. And that's why when you look at the Apostle Paul, he was able church, Brother Timothy, he was able to encourage all those that he came in contact with because he had come to the point, him and Paul and Silas, they began to pray